Hello everyone, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. To know about this video code in Excel function, watch the video till the end, and if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone. Today we have a topic with us is a code in Excel function. This is basically a text and a string function in Excel, which we are going to use to make you understand that how exactly it works. See, the code function is one of the most advanced function in Excel. The main purpose of the code function is to return the ASCII code of characters. Okay, so that is the whole agenda of the first character of any cell. Now, ASCII stands for American Standard of Code for Information Interchange, and it is an encoding standard for characters for electronic exchange. So, you know, whenever the code function is categorized as a text function in Excel, it returns to the corresponding number, numerical ASCII value of characters. Now, the code function is not much popular among the Excel community, but as an Excel expert, you should be aware of this kind of function, as you might find it handy while VBA coding that you are doing in the course. Okay, let me start the formula. You start the formula by saying is equal to code. You'll see a text. So the code function uses only one parameter. Now, the text parameter is only a mandatory parameter of code function, and these parameter could be one single character, or it can be a string or any function which returns to the text, or it can be a result. Now, how to use this kind of a code function in Excel? So in this section, we will understand and know how exactly to use the code function, and we will look at few examples with the help of some of the actual data. Now, it is really very important to understand, as explained in the previous section, as in the previous conversation that I was having, the code function uses only one parameter. Okay, now let me go to the example number one so that you will have an idea. As you can see, there are characters from A to E with a formula and output data. Now, as you clearly observe in the output section, the code function is returning the ASCII value of the corresponding character written in the first column. And it is written in the first column, and ASCII value of A is 65. And for the small a is going to be what we call as 97. So all you need to do is just you can write the formula is equal to code, copy the text here. You'll see 65. For B, it is 66, and so on and so forth. For small a, see the difference. For the big A, it is 65. And from the small a, it shows us 97. So you can easily verify the ASCII values of every character of the keyboard form of the internet. So over here, the output, this is what is the formula. Okay, you can remove is equal to from, and everything is going to remain the same, just inputting the formula here. Now, example number two, you have a string and sentences over here, couple of string and sentence here. We will write a formula to understand this particular scenario. So we'll write is equal to code, we'll say text function, and drag it down. Just use the same thing and drag it down again. So in the above example, we have applied the code function on cells that is containing the strings. So as you can see in the output column, the code function is returning the ASCII values of the first character of the sentence. Let's go to example number three. Here, again, it's the same thing, but we will use something different. In this particular scenario, we'll say that we'll use is equal to code. Inside that, we will use a lower function and use a lower text A17, close the bracket. It will show us opposite. Now, why like this? See, in this example, 3, we have used another two function called lower and upper. So over here, just change it to upper. So it will reverse the scenario. Okay. In this example, we have used both of the function, the lower and the upper, to use their return values of the parameter of code function. So the lower function returns the lower case of the character passed as a parameter. And similarly, the upper returns the upper case of the character that have been passed as a parameter. Well, after running through all the examples, the function should be really quite clear in this particular regards. But before that, we have some of the things to remember. Let me make you understand first. This particular function was first introduced in Excel 2000 and is available in all the subsequent version in Excel. Second, the parameter text over here is in code. It is in code function. It is mandatory. And if it is left blank, the function will return to the so-called value error. Now, this can be easily be resolved by providing a proper character or string in this particular regards and as a parameter function. Okay. Third, now the return of the type of code function is basically it's a numerical value. Fourth, it is actually the inverse. If you see, it is the inverse of the CHAR function in Excel. Okay. And the CHAR function, it returns the corresponding character from a numerical ASCII value. Fifth, now you might observe a different, output, you can say that, than the one that is shown in our examples on macOS, because macOS uses Macintosh characters set while Windows uses ANSI characters of set. Well, that's it for this particular topic. I hope you, and if you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone once again for joining the session. Cheers.